Hello and welcome back to Kino-Plays Resident Evil 3 Remake, Part 5. Let's go. See if there's anything down here first before I head over to get the kendos. Ooh. Worth it. Just 21 shots. And nothing else to collect. So I can go into kendos. Can't go through there though. Ooh.
You're all right to stretch. Sorry I got a little jumpy there. Didn't know quite what to expect.
No shit. Look, we're using the subway to get people out of town. You in?
Subway. Well, that's good thinking.
When we get out, there's gonna be a lot to do. We can use a man of your skill set. What's wrong?
Nothing. Just bad timing is all. Look, don't worry about me. I'm gonna make other arrangements, okay?
You better. You're the best gunsmith around.
Oh, no.
Don't do anything stupid.
Oh, that's your job, right? Take care, Jill.
Oh. Poor Kendo. Okay. Wait, where was that? Ah. I missed a red herb during the fight. That would have helped. I wonder what that looks like in Resident Evil 2. I don't remember looking at that building. Yeah, I thought so. Oh, come on. Them ones. Shit. Whoa, okay. Didn't realize it had that much range. That looks like it's gonna be trouble. Let's see what's upstairs. Raccoon Times Reader's Column. Dear Editor, I'm writing to you because I am troubled, deeply troubled. Anyone who's been a parent knows that Crystal Promenade is the place to take your kids for a trip downtown on Sundays. On Sundays? Saturdays. And there's no store more popular or harder on a parent's wallet than Toy Uncle. However, I've noticed that on windy days, the big statue above the entrance wobbles like the only thing holding it up is a couple of screws. If that statue's head tumbles loose on a busy day, children will be badly hurt. I've complained to the manager 3 times now, but he just isn't willing to rectify the situation. Are we supposed to wait for a terrible accident to happen before taking action? No. If heads are going to roll, then let it be the managers. Take that death trap down. So that's why he's got grenade launcher ammo. Do a bit of domestic terrorism for the sake of the chillins. That just sounded off. Children. God damn it. Right. This looks like a trap. Motherfucker! Oof. Woo. Oh crap, I've got no ammo at all now. Well, at least I know to not bother fighting him this time. Really thought he would have dropped something really good during that fight. I mean, if you're gonna face off head on with a guy with a rocket launcher, he should at least drop you an upgrade. Ah, crap. Well, this time I won't wait. I'll just run. Oof. Okay. Too far. Wait, what? Okay, RPGs take out vehicles. How the hell does she survive that? Okay. Full health, but moving around like she's critically injured. Seriously? Right, you're going to use the petrol station to blow the bastard up. Oh, okay, using landmine. Claymores. I shouldn't have wasted that ammo then.
Carlos, I know we didn't get off to a great start. Thanks for the save.
Hey, you saved my ass first. You're a hell of a lot braver than me.
What matters is that we can get everyone out of the city now.
Yeah. Yeah, you'll be safe.
What about you?
From the sound of it, I won't be catching the train.
Why not?
No, there'll be new orders. If it means I can help save the city, it's fine by me.
This isn't the last ride out of town, right?
Do not worry. Once the civilians are safe, the train will be back.
It's all right. You're going ahead. I'm not going to die on you. Leave you in a cold, cruel, Carlos's world.
You'll need to find this scientist. His vaccine research could save us all.
You see? You're learning. The only life that matters.
Good luck. Let's go.
What the hell are you talking about? The last time you saw me, I sacrificed myself to lead Nemesis away. I haven't done anything selfish that you know of. Weird.
You don't really think you pin some pusher like part of his life, do you?
I haven't done good authority. something else. Funny how brainless zombies can ambush a platoon like that. Funny the gate was locked. Don't you think?
Apparently, those are the civilians getting massacred. I guess they're not the survivors from Operation Outbreak.
Ooh.
Blowing you the fuck up. Get over here! Oh, I would have laughed so hard if that hadn't detonated.
Subway's gotta be clear of the city by now.
Along with your hot date.
Nah, she's not like that. Hell, she's not like anybody.
Alright, keep your head screwed on, Romeo. This is the police station.
You sure? It looks like a cemetery to me.
Okay, knife, hang on. Machine gun. Not bad. Not great ammo, though. So this is how Marvin gets bit. God damn it, Brad. This is for Marvin, you motherfucker. Something about his running looks really wrong.
Somebody didn't have time to put his blues on.
Making it canon that it's Leon's story B that he follows. Email outbox, sender, Lucy Yen. Subject, disposal complete. Sent September 26, 2:35 a.m. Department in chaos after spread of infection. Multiple citizens taking refuge here are infected. All files related to you successfully disposed of. Awaiting further orders. Sender, Lucy Yen. Subject, ongoing developments. Sent September 27th, 3:05 a.m. Communications interrupted from South Hospital on Star's private communications line. Presumed to be evac request from B. Possible he will flee the hospital and come here. Request UBCS dispatch. I will evacuate with their assistance. And then Lucy N. Evacuation request sent September 27th, 11:54 p.m. Requested evac has not yet arrived. This position is becoming untenable. I remained here with the condition my safety would be guaranteed. If I am left to die here, I will distribute proof of collusion and corruption between you and RC's civic leaders. You have 1 hour to deliver a response.
Sorry, poster boy.
Where'd that cop go?
Where'd that cop go?
Don't know, don't care.
Don't care.
We got a job to do.
Our intel's still worth it.
The large and stars are.
Let's find him and take him into custody.
Find him and take him into custody.
Custody?
Custody?
I thought this was a rescue.
I thought this was a rescue.
Carlos, take a look at this.
Take a look at this.
I've located the stars office. Remember. Bard had access to Umbrella's darkest secrets. He knows we'll try to keep him under our thumbs.
So this search and rescue mission is really more like find and detain. Right. Good to know.
I'll open the shutter so you can get through.
You stay here and find out what's been going on here at the station.
Call you if I find anything.
Hey! Hey! Be careful.
Yeah. You too, man. Now here's a weird fucking door.
Weird fucking door. We're here for bar.
Yeah, for a minute I thought there was something to pick up. ID card security protocols. September 16th, 1998. Each member of the force has been issued an ID card. From now on, this same card will be required to access all storage boxes. Do not lend your card to anyone. Take great care in using it. If your card goes missing, report it lost immediately. RPD Facility Maintenance Department. Part of the sofa's clipping through the box. Oh, you numbnuts. Liquors. Great.
Big warm RPD welcome.
copy? There's something real nasty in here. I don't know what it is. I don't know what it is.
Something nasty. All right. I'll take a look with the camera. Watch your six.
Okay, great. Ooh. Oh, I could have sworn that looked like it popped then. September 20th, arrest report. Name, Rodney Gray. Occupation, unemployed. Former electrician. Charges, unlawful creation and or possession of explosives. Well, that explains those explosives from number two. Narrative. Suspect was seen behaving suspiciously at 1442 Box Street on September 18th, 1998. Suspect person was searched, producing a small explosive and a timed detonator from his inside pocket, leading to arrest on the charges listed above. A search of suspect's home found more than 20 additional homemade explosives at various stages of completion. Suspect was extremely agitated and not of sound mind. Suspect spoke feverishly when questioning began, and at one point questioning had to be halted due to a sudden bout of shrieking from suspect. Once questioning was resumed, suspect made the following statements. I didn't do it for me, I did it for you. Why doesn't anyone understand? The corpse is attacked from the shadows. A storm's coming, but this umbrella is no good. Gotta blow it up or you'll be more than just wet. Gotta get more bombs. They're coming. Soon. Gotta hurry. Burn them. Burn the corpses. Burn them good. During questioning, the suspect began to shake violently before resuming a shrieking fit. Questioning was ended and a sedative administered. Note, due to suspect's unstable psychiatric condition, Suspect's testimony changed from moment to moment. Suspect's delirium made any sort of dialogue impossible. We are currently awaiting the results of a doctor's investigation into suspect's condition. The explosives collected from suspect's person and residence appear to be extremely powerful. As a safety precaution, a battery was removed from one detonation device upon its admission into evidence. The battery was secured in the safety deposit room. Interrogating officer, Wes Drucker. Cool. Not allowed to interact with Leon's desk. I have no idea what the damn combination was on this. Just random. Would have been funny if that worked. Ah, 9:15:07. Okay. Internal memo. September 22nd, 1998. Office supply internal relocation notice. Heat resistant 3-number combination safe moved from Star's office second floor to West office first floor. Combo is 9:15:07. Please change the combo ASAP upon receipt. Maintenance department. 9:15:07. Okay. Hey, more storage. Thank you.
Kill those things, I'd be set.
Fair enough.
Why is it blocked?
Note to a friend. Hector, if you're reading this, I'm already dead. Do you hear if you hear any noises coming from the locker, do not open it, please. While you were out on patrol, I focused on finding a way to get to the other side. I realised that explosives might be our best bet. I managed to rig up a pretty good bomb, but we don't have any batteries for the detonator. I'm pretty sure I sent one to the safety deposit room during intake last week. We need that battery if we're going to knock down this wall. So I headed upstairs to find you since I know you have the safety deposit room key. As soon as I left the shower room, I was attacked. One of them bit me. I washed the wound as best I could, but I feel worse and worse. I hope I don't need to spell out why you must not open the locker. Please don't worry about me. Just get yourself out of here as soon as you can. Your buddy, Wes. P.S. Don't worry about that 600 I lent you. Think of it as a gift towards your upcoming move. Good luck, buddy. May as well leave that there. There's no reason to carry it, I don't think. So, it's not Nemesis that comes busting through that wall. You use a bomb.
Better not. Better not.
Wait, what? Yeah, would have been nice if that had worked for both. Okay, so we either need to use a bomb here to go through, or Nemesis will be attacking me here in the police station. Either way, not good. Oh, okay. DCM. Okay. Okay, 104, 6, and 9.
I've hit a dead end with the terminal here. Gotta head your way.
Copy that.
Okay, I'm gonna call that here for now.